Hello students, so today we'll study new lesson 11, Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. So this Microsoft PowerPoint is a application, is a presentation software, and it is used to create a PPT file. And this PPT file contains slides. So this presentation is a collection of slides, and these slides are arranged in a sequential manner to convey, persuade, motivate, or entertain, or to provide the information. So this slide is also called a digital page or the electronic page of a presentation. And many other popular presentation softwares are the Adobe Connect, Google Slide, and OpenOffice. And OpenOffice Impress belongs to the Linux operating system. So see how we start this Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. So this is a presentation software used to create the dynamic slide presentations that include the animation, narration, images, and videos. Means slide contains. It is a graphical software package used for creating the effective multimedia presentation. It is also a part of the Microsoft Office 2010 suite. So let me show you how to so first of all go on the start button. Now after that we will search here Microsoft Office. Now you'll find this Microsoft Office. Now click on this Microsoft Office, scroll down, you'll find the Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. See, this is, click on this. Now Microsoft PowerPoint 2010 will open like this. Okay, so this is the window of the Microsoft PowerPoint, as you can see. So the topmost bar is called the title bar. This will this contains the name of the application. By default, the name of the PPT is presentation one, and this is the close button. Now if you want to create a blank slide, that we have to learn, you have to click on the file tab. There you find the new, this is the blank presentation. Click on the create. Now see, the blank presentation is open. Now if you want to let me close this. There is a close button to close this presentation. Now again, I will go on the file tab. Click on the new. So if you want to use a template, means pre-designed slide, in which the background and other things are designed, so go on the sample templates. Now here, see, different templates are there. So let me select this. Go on the create. Now see, this is the designed slides. It is open. Now here you can add the content. These are the different placeholders. Okay, so here click on this. Now see, the delete the previous thing, introducing PowerPoint. So you can, the place of this, you can write any other thing. Suppose you can write about the water conservation. The title I have, water conservation. Similarly, you can delete this one also. And on the place of PowerPoint 2010, you can write some other thing also. Okay. Here you can write the content. So these are the different components which I have shown you, components of the PowerPoint window. So this is the slide pen. This is the placeholders, which I have shown you. This is the title bar. Now in the quick access toolbar, it is also called a customizable toolbar, which contains the commands that you may want to use quite often. By default, this toolbar is located on the title bar. Just similar to the Microsoft Word. The function of the quick access toolbar is just similar to that in the Microsoft Word. This contains the frequently used buttons, frequently used commands tools. Ribbon placed on the top area of the main window. It displays the several tabs: file, home, insert, design, transition, animation, slide, so review, view, and acrobat. All these are the present in the ribbon. File tab, the office button of the Microsoft 2007 is replaced by the file tab in the office 2010. Slides pen is a blank area in the middle of the window where you can design the slides. Slide steps, so the thumbnail or miniature version of this slide, which I have shown you. This is the thumbnail. This is the miniature view. If you click on the outline, see, it will show you the outline of the slide, what the conservation, what I am written, and the only text you will find in that outline of all the slides. So status bar is positioned at the bottom of the PowerPoint window. It displays the important information about the current slides. Now we move to the now what are the rules, guidelines to make the effective presentation. So to make a good presentation, effective presentation, keep the slide simple. Means always try to keep your presentation simple by using the charts on the slides, which are easy to understand, and graphics that reflect what you are saying. Minimize facts and figures on in the slides. So use less number of facts, use less numbers on the slides. PowerPoint has the capacity to convey the ideas and support a speaker's remarks in a concise manner. So you should avoid to include too many figures and numbers. Use vibrant colors, striking colors, as you seen I have. Use a slide which has a good background. Import the images, graphics and videos. Use humor in your presentation. Edit ruthlessly. If suppose any content you are finding, if any text you are finding which is unappealing, distracting, confusing, so remove it. Hold up your end with enticing or convincing material. Means on the slide you have to put such a material which helps you to deliver the presentation, which helps to deliver your ideas. So build a strong PowerPoint presentation, but make sure your spoken remarks should be appealing also to the ears of listeners. If you are not a good orator, if you are not a good communicator, if you are not able to communicate your ideas, so your slide is not going to do for you. So don't parrot the PowerPoint. Never read the visual presentation in front of the audience. It makes even the most visually appealing presentation boring to be done. So if in front of the audience you are reading the content of the slide only, so audience get bored, because the audience are there to listen something about your own, not they are sitting just only to see you while reading. So make eye to eye contact with your audience, because when you read the slide content, you'll back will be facing to the audience, so the audience feel bored by seeing your backs only. So time your remarks. So proper care should be taken while giving the remarks. Your comments should not coincide precisely with the appearance of the press PowerPoint slides. So the slide which you are showing, your so what the slide you are showing, so your presentation should be related to that only. Making a powerful first impression. So first impression is the last impression, is a good proverb, as you know. So you cannot make a first impression twice. So the audience will make decision about you from your first appearance only. So try to give your first impression as a best impression. In the next, see, these are the different elements of the slide. These are the elements of the slide: background, title, body text, date, footer. So here you see the background. Background is the base of the slide on which the various elements like title, images, charts, etc. is added. Title is the heading of the slide, which is used to guide the audience and about the content. Body text contains the main content of the slide. Footer, this area at the bottom slide used to specify the organization name or slide show theme. This is the optional bit, it's not mandatory to write something on the footer. Date and time displayed at the bottom of the slide is in the footer region. Slide number is also located at the bottom of the slide on the footer region. Different types of the slide layouts. There are many types of the slide layouts that we show on this, on the PowerPoint. So here in the home tab, see, there are the new slide button. Click on the drop down list, see, it will show you the many different types of the slide layout. Title, slide, section, header, title and content. Title and content emphasis, 9 types of titles, 2 content, title only, and content with caption, title with text, title only, emphasis, media with caption, picture with caption, title and vertical text. So picture with caption, see if I use it here. So here it is used to insert a picture any on the slide. So click on this, so a picture will be added. See, the insert picture dialog box is open. Now from here I want to insert any image. So from the camera roll, is there any image that I'll show you. Leave it at. So let me the add the image of this one which I have. So this see one image I have added. This is the question of geometry. So here you can write the title. Okay, that I have added the image of triangle. So I can write the triangle. Sorry, triangle like this. Okay. I can add the images with the help of the clip art also. So any other also we can take. Suppose two content we are taking here. In this we can add the images from the clip art also. See, I click on the clip art option. So this clip art is open. So here I'm searching the image for the tree. One image I got, click on it. Now see, this image of tree is added on the. Here it is added. Okay. Click on it and you can write the text here. So I can write here the tree. Okay, like this. Now here we can change the background of the slide. So if you want to change the background of the slide, go on the design and you can here see select any design of the slide so that the design of the slide is changed. Again move. So how to add the text? Now I have shown you that by clicking on the placeholder, cursor will appear. Now you can type the content. Built-in template as design I have shown you. Now move to the next topic. So how to save the presentation? So what I have prepared, that we can save it by clicking on the save button as you are doing in the Microsoft Word, similar. So write your presentation name, my presentation, and click on the save button. So let me show you how to save it. That also you know. Suppose this I want to save it. So in the file you go. So there is a save button. Click on the save. It will ask you the name here, water conservation. Click on the save. Yes, it already existing this file. So click on no. I will write here after water conservation. I will add one because water conservation file I have prepared already. Now click on the save. Now it is saved. So next thing is also here. The presentation will be saved with the extension .pptx. Yes, the .pptx is the extension of the PowerPoint file. So now we move to the next topic. How to set the password for a file for any PPT. So here, so we can save the presentation using password protection. So one cannot read it without typing the password. So this we have again. See how we do. We have to click on the file tab, go on the save option. Save as dialog box will appear. There you find the option tools tab. So click on the tool. There you find the general option. So let me show you. So here, click on the save as dialog box. Save as dialog box will open. It's already saved, man. Oh no. So here it is the tools tab. Click on this tools tab. There you find the general option. Now it will ask the see password to open. So here you can put some password to open. Any password you can type it. Suppose I have typed the password here, and it will ask the password. Click on OK. Re-enter the password to open. Again it is asking the password. You confirm it. Again I have entered. Now click on OK. Now the password is set. Now suppose if I'll close this presentation, water conservation one. So I have to type the password. Save it, man. Without entering password I cannot open. Okay, so let me again open the that I have closed. Okay, no problem. Let me open it again. Sorry. Go on the Microsoft Office. This is the Microsoft Office. Click. Now there you find the Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. Now it is open. Okay. Now here I will go on the file. There is the open. will show you. Water conservation, I went. Water conservation one, yes. Now open. Now see to lock the password before opening. Now see, enter password to open the file. Now when I will enter the password, then only it will be open, otherwise it will not be open. So see, I have entered the password. Now I'll click on OK. Now the content is open. See, that is the thing here. Again, I have closed, man. Leave it. Similarly, we set the password to modify also. Now to close the presentation, again we go on the file tab, there you find the option close, click on the close, it will be closed. How you opening your presentation? So that we have shown you how you to open the presentation. Go on the file tab, there you find the open option. Click on open to lock the file name, type the file name and it will be open. Next is how to apply the shadow effect and how to apply the font style. So this is all for the today's students. In the next class we'll study about this. So thank you for your kind attention.